Hello students, welcome to CMIS online classes, and this chapter is for class 9, chapter number 4, the structure of the atom. So in our third chapter we talked about atoms and molecules. We already discussed about what do you mean by atom and what molecules constitute, but in this chapter we will be talking about atomic structure. Or the structure of an atom. That means, as we all know, atom is the lowest undivisible part of an element. Okay, so that also constitutes some features. That means we can say that electron, proton and neutron. So in this chapter we will be talking about electron, proton and neutron. Okay, so let's start with this structure. So atoms are a revolving of a molecules. Okay, revolving of a atomic particles. That means electron, proton and neutron. Okay. So charged particles in matter. First we will talk about charged particles. Atoms have three different types of subatomic particles. They are electron, protons and neutrons, as I have talked. Electrons are negatively charged, protons are positively charged particles. Okay, and neutrons have no charge. That means they are neutral. So negative charged particles are electron, positive charged particles are protons, and those who don't have any charge, neither positive nor negative, we termed it as neutrons. Okay, so the mass of an electron is 1 by 2000 the mass of hydrogen atom. So if we take a atom of an hydrogen, so electron is almost 1 by 2000 of the mass. That means we can say that it's divisible by 2000. So it's very small particles. The mass of the proton is equal to mass of the hydrogen atom. So the proton is equal to the mass of hydrogen atom. That means the positive charge. And is taken as one unit. So the mass of the neutron is equal to the mass of the hydrogen atom and is taken as one unit. So neutron also can be taken as one unit and proton also can be taken as one unit. But electron, it's a 1 by 2000 times the mass of an hydrogen atom. Okay, so now we can say that we have charged particles in the atom. The negative charged particles is electron, positive charge particle is proton, and neutrons have no charges. Okay, now discovery of subatomic particles. That means who discovered those particles? Electron, proton and neutron. So in 1900, J.J. Thomson discovered the presence of negatively charged particles. Okay, and called electrons in the atom. Okay, so J.J. Thomson was the person who discovered the presence of electron, which is also called as negatively charged particles. But before him, in 1886, E. Goldstein discovered new radiation in gas discharge and called them canal rays. These rays were positively charged. This later led to the discovery of positively charged particles called protons. That means before the discovery of electron, protons were discovered, but in the name of canal rays by E. Goldstein. Okay. Then in 1932, James Chadwick discovered the presence of particles having no charge in the atom called neutrons. So we can say that first of all, in 1900, J.J. Thomson discovered electron. that is negatively charged. In 1932, neutrons was discovered by Chadwick. And in 1886, proton was discovered, but in the name of Canal Rays. Later, it was more studied and named as protons. Okay? So, let's move to another part, that is structure of an atom. So, atom are made up of smaller particles called electron, protons and neutrons. So we can say that atoms are made up of electron, proton and neutron. An atom consists of a cloud of electrons surrounding a small dense nucleus of protons and neutrons. That means electron is surrounded by protons and neutrons. And electrons and protons have a property called electric charge. That means negative charge and positive charge, which affect the way they interact with each other and with other electrically charged particles. That's why we can say that due to these particles only, various elements combine to form a molecules. As we have an example of hydrogen and oxygen. Okay, due to the opposite charged particles, hydrogen is combined to oxygen to form water. Okay. Now, nucleus of the atom. What is nucleus? An atom consists of a cloud of electrons surrounding a small, dense nucleus of protons and neutrons. The nucleus contains nearly all of the masses of the atom. But it occupies only a tiny fraction of the space inside the atom. That means the nucleus occupies only the tiny fraction of the space inside the atom. The diameter of a typical nucleus is only about 1 into 10 to the power minus 14 m. Okay, or about 1 by 1 lakh of the diameter of the entire atom. That means if you divide atom into 1 lakh particles, then one particle is that of a nucleus. Now let's talk about electron. As we discussed electrons was discovered by J.J. Thomson. Okay, electrons are tiny negatively charged particles. So that also we can conclude that electrons are negatively charged particles around the nucleus of an atom. So each electron carries a single fundamental unit of negatively charged, negative electric charge, which is 1.602 into 10 to the power 19 coulombs. Coulomb is its unit and has a mass of 9.109 into 10 to the power 31 kg. So kg is the unit of mass. See, the electron is one of the lightest particles with a known mass. So we can say that electron is lighter than proton and neutron. An electron cannot be split into anything smaller. That means it is the lowest subparticles of an atom. Also, electrons do not have any real size but are instead true. That means electrons, they don't have real size. Their size can differ from one element to another. Okay, in hydrogen atom, the electron may be smaller or bigger than the oxygen atom. Okay, points in space, that is an electron, do not have points and do not have radius of zero. Okay, so this was all about electrons. Okay, now let's move to neutron. So it was discovered by James Chadwick. The neutron is slightly heavier than a proton. That means neutron is slightly heavier than proton and 1838 times as heavy as the electron. So we can say that the lightest particle is electron, then proton and then neutron. okay. So neutron, electrically neutron, elementary particles, that is a part of the nucleus of the atom. That means neutron is the part of the nucleus of the atom, that means which is fixed at the center of an atom. The neutron is about 10 to the power 13 centimeter in diameter and weighs 1.6749 into 10 to the power minus 27 kg. So we can conclude that how small a neutron can be, because its diameter is 10 to the power minus 13 centimeter and its weight is almost 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 27 kg. Okay, so this was all about neutrons. Now we will talk about protons. We talk about electrons, we talk about neutrons. Now let's have a discussion on protons. So atoms are made of extremely tiny particles called protons, neutrons and electrons. Protons and neutrons are in the center of the atom, making up the nucleus. So proton and neutron, they act in the center of an atom, okay, which constitute nucleus. An electron surrounds the nucleus. That means, surrounds means it acts like the planets. Okay, and nucleus act as like a sun. So protons have a positive charge. Electrons have a negative charge. That was discussed by us in our previous discussion. So let's have a differentiate the three particles, that is electron, proton and neutron. So electron, the symbol of electron is E and minus. Why minus? Because it is negatively charged particles. Proton, we can write small p and a plus sign because it is positively charged element. And neutron, we don't have any symbol of it. And charge is, of electron it is minus 1, proton plus 1 and neutron 0. That means it is neither positive charge nor negative charge. And we have a mass of these three subatomic particles. As for example, for electron, the mass of the electron is 9 into 10 to the power minus 31 kg. Similarly, proton have 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 27 kg. And neutron, 1.67 into 10 to the power 27 kg. Means we can say that mass of neutron and proton is similar because it makes up the nucleus and is situated at the center of an atom, whereas electron, it revolves around the nucleus, okay, like the planets. Now let's move towards Thomson model of an atom. According to Thomson, an atom is more similar to a Christmas pudding. The pudding has positive charge and the electrons having negative charge were like plums on the pudding. He proposed that an atom consists of a positively charged sphere and the electrons are embedded on it. Okay, so atoms consist of positive charged sphere and electrons are embedded on it. Electrons have been added on it. Whereas the negative and the positive charge are equal in magnitude. So both negative and positive charge are equal in magnitude. So the atom as a whole is electrically neutral because it has equal magnitude of negative charge particles and positively charged particles. Okay, so let's talk about Rutherford model of an atom. So the Rutherford alpha scattering experiment. Okay, so Rutherford was the person who did an experiment and we will talk about that experiment. So he allowed a beam of fast moving alpha particles. having positive charge to fall on a thin gold foil. What he observed is that most of the alpha particles pass straight through the gold foil. That means most of the particles, it passed straight. And some of the alpha particles were slightly deflected by some angles. Okay, we can see in the figure. And few alpha particles appeared to rebound. Rebound means reflected back. Okay, just we can see here that he just allowed a beam of fast moving alpha particles. Okay, having positive charge to fall on a gold foil. So most of the alpha particles passed straight through the foil, and a few was slightly deflected, as we can see in the second figure, and a very few were bounced off. That means they were rebound or they were reflected. Okay, so he did experiment to see that what happens if alpha particles is having positive charge falls on a metal, that means gold foil. After that, what he concluded from the scattering of alpha particles. So his conclusion was, most of the space inside an atom is empty. So atom is not dense. Most of it's empty. That's why the alpha particles just pass through the gold foil. Otherwise, if it could have been dense, okay, all the particles would have reflected. Okay, because most of the alpha particles pass straight through the gold foil. So the atom has a small nucleus having positive charge. Okay, that means we can say that due to the same charge, they get deflected by some angles. Okay, so atoms has a small nucleus having positively charged, and alpha particles having positive charge was passed. But what happened in the second case was the particles were slightly deflected. That means we can conclude that the positive charge of the nucleus and the positive charge of the alpha particles, okay, they were not attracted, they were deflected. That's why the alpha particles deflected by some angles. The size of the nucleus is very small compared to the size of the atom, because very few alpha particles appear to rebound. And most of the positive charge and mass of the atom is in the nucleus. That means the size of the nucleus was very small. So these three was Rutherford's conclusion by scattering alpha particles. Now Rutherford's model of an atom. An atom has a positively charged nucleus at its center, and most of the mass of the atom is in the nucleus. So that was his conclusion. Then the electron revolved round the nucleus in different orbits. That means the electron revolved round the protons and neutrons, which constitute a nucleus. The size of the nucleus is very small compared to the size of the atom. So this was all a model of Rutherford after his experiment. Now, defects of Rutherford model. What was its defect? So, three conclusions he made, but some defects also is observed. So, any particles in a circular orbit would undergo acceleration, and during acceleration, the charged particles would radiate energy. So, the revolving electron would lose energy and fall into the nucleus, and the atom would be unstable. As we know that atoms are stable, they are fixed. But the defect was that atom would be unstable due to his experiments. Okay, so that was his defect. means drawbacks. We can say that was his drawbacks. Okay, so we came to know about Rutherford model in this session.